Hello students, in last video we discussed about distinguish between bills of exchange and promissory note, and after that we discussed about the types of due date or maturity due date, means meaning of nominal due date and legal due date. Again I am repeating the same. Nominal due date means the date before adding 3 days, and legal due date means after adding 3 days of grace. Now with one example we see how to calculate due date. Actually in exam calculation of due date is not there, but whenever the question is there, dates are given, at that time you have to calculate due date. Or sometimes in objectives also, in fill in the blanks, this question can be asked. Suppose the day bill prepared on a particular date, and after 30 days maturity date is there, then you have to select or calculate the due date. So you must know how to calculate the due date. See, there are three types actually: after date, after site bill, and on demand or at site bills. These are the three types of bills for calculation. After date means whenever in the specimen, this I already told you when I explained you about the specimens of bills of exchange. In specimen, we write over there 90 days after the date. Sometimes we may write 90 days after site, or sometimes the bills are not on the period, on demand pay to me or my order, or at site pay to me or my order. So these are the three types of bills according to the dates of the bill. First, after date. So whenever the period starts, what is first difference between after date, after site, and on demand or at site? After date means what? When period of the bill starts after the date of the bill. Now I assume that you know the meaning of date of the bill. Date of the bill means what? When the bill drawn by the drawer. After site means when bill accepted by the drawee. The period start from that date. And on demand means there is no particular period is given. On demand or at site means whenever asked by the drawer, or wherever drawer present the bill, at that time you have to pay. So these are the three difference between after date, after site, and on demand. Now we are going to in detail. First, after date. In after date also there are two parts. If term is given in months, whenever term is given in months, you have to calculate month wise. And whenever term given in days, you have to calculate days wise. 90 days means don't think that 3 months are there, so we will directly calculate 3 months. In whenever period is given in days, you have to calculate in days only. Now, first term given in months. Suppose this is one of the example. Date of the bill is suppose 12th June 2019. And period 2 months. So the period start from 12th June. Date of the bill 12th June plus 2 months. 2 months means 12th June to 12th July, 12th August. 12th August is nominal due date. Means the date when actually the period gets over. After that, legally on every bill we have to add 3 days. So here also we are adding 3 days of grace. So legal due date is 15th August 2019. Now 15th August, as you know, this is our Independence Day, public holiday. Whenever any public holiday, bill matures on any public holiday or Sunday, then the 1 day before that bill will get mature, means 14th August. Miss drawee has to make the payment of the bill, or drawer has a right to ask for the payment of the bill on 14th August, because 15th August is holiday. So 15th August, 1st May, 26th Jan, like this way, whenever public holidays are there, and if bill falls mature on that date, then the bill get mature one day early, one day before. Keep in mind this always, because here confusion always arises and student get confused and they mark a wrong answer. So whenever on public holiday, bill matures one day before. Now if term is given in dates, suppose the date of the bill is 14th December 2019 and period 90 days. So now month, how to calculate this? This is first column month and unexpired days of that particular month. From 14th December, we have to calculate 90 days. So in December, December is of 31st, 31 days minus 14 days which already expired. So what are the unexpired days? 17, 31 minus 14. Then January, again year change here. Keep in mind 2020. So 31 days. January is of 31 days. February. In case of February, always keep in mind sometimes February is there for 28 and sometimes 29. So when 29 days are there, whenever there is leap year. That you have to, you must know which year is leap year. The year which is fully, totally divisible by 4 is known as leap year. 2020 leap year, that's why 29 days. March, again 13 days we require. You can take total up to this and after that add the days of March, 13 days. So here total 90 days. Now nominal due date is what? 13th March. Again add 3 days of grace. So legal due date is 16th March 20. See, whenever calculation in days wise, calculate in days wise. Suppose here 90 days are there. And if you think that we will make it 3 months, then what will happen? December, January, February, March. You will come here 14th March. But 14th March plus 3 days of grace. So what will be there? 17th March. But actually due date is what? 16th March. You will get wrong answer. So that's why whenever calculation is in days wise, calculate in days wise only. Is it clear? Now second is after sight. Method of calculation of due date is same for after date and after sight. Only the difference is that the term of bill is counted from the date of acceptance and not from the date of bill drawn. Means the calculation is same. But in the question, there may be acceptance date is given to you and you have to calculate from the date of acceptance, not from the date of the bill. Then last is on demand or at sight bill. These bills are payable on presentation to the drawee. So there is no question of due date and grace period arises. When the drawer make the present the bill, at that time only drawee has to make the payment of the bill. So on demand or at sight bill, there is no question of due date or grace period is also not given to the drawee. Is it clear? After date, after sight, on demand or at sight. In next video, we will discuss about various types of bills of exchange. Thank you.